Hi, let's talk about coagulation and flocculation. The particles in liquid suspension often remain suspended due to their small size and electric charge. Most of these particles have a negative charge. As a result, they keep repelling each other and fail to settle. Coagulation is a phenomenon in which we add salts to cause their aggregation. These salts have positively charged metal ions. Because of opposite charge, the suspended particles are attracted towards the metal ion and form aggregates. The aggregation of suspended particles in presence of metal ions is known as coagulation. Once the aggregate becomes heavy, it settles down. These heavy aggregated particles, which are settling down, are termed as flocs. And the mechanism is termed as flocculation by coagulation. This means we have formed these flocs by the addition of coagulants like metal ions. So always remember this, when metal ions causes the suspended particles to come close, it is known as coagulation. And the formation of large clumps, which settles down after coagulation, is termed as flocculation. Now let's understand the terms coagulants and flocculants. So coagulants are mostly salts having inorganic metal ions which have positive charge in water. The flocculants, on the other hand, are large, high molecular weight polymers which can be chemically synthesized or they can be biological. The use of these high molecular weight polymer to cause aggregation of particle is termed as direct flocculation. That is, we are directly using the flocculant without the addition of coagulant. These long high molecular weight polymers can interact with the suspended particles in two ways. First one is by bridge formation, and second one is by electrostatic patching mechanism. Let's understand both the phenomenon. In bridge formation, the large polymer binds the tiny suspended particles and forms a bridge between them. Because of this binding, the overall structure becomes heavy and it settles down, resulting in flocculation. In electrostatic patching mechanism, the polymer binds a small portion of the particle. This binding neutralizes the charge on the particle. Now the polymer bound with the particle attracts the other particle because of opposite charge. This phenomenon keeps on repeating until it results in formation of large flocs, which easily settles down. Now there are several parameters which affects coagulation and flocculation. One of the most important parameter is the pH. Since pH can affect the net charge on the functional groups, the pH of solution must be kept optimum. Besides pH, agitation of solution or mixing of solution also plays an important role. Mixing allows collision between the flocculant and the suspended particles. This allows formation of large flocs and results in optimum clearing of the solution.